going to say. I'll be back in a sec. Are we restarting? No, because we've read it up early. It's not even 02 yet. I'll do that. Yeah. I'm still going to take this as practice. Hey, what's it put? What was it, M that read it up? Had a shock rubber first. I don't know. What the? You can't. We won't have a restart. Yeah. Truthfully, mate, I've got no idea. I'm gonna run the setup we've initially discussed. Yep. Can I have an invite to the session, sir, please? Oh, 42 dead! 142,000. Bloody brilliant.
Good job, mate. Really, really well done. That was a fantastic drive. Bring it home.
Am I? What makes you think that? Oh, half the session asked. Brilliant. I'm joining the session now. I think I'm running the initial setup I was going to. Just careful with the balance because you've been obviously using something completely different. It depends. Most of your points will come from the feature, and you'll get a better feature if you get a good quality. I'd say maybe put them both up by like one or two. Good luck, lads. Good luck. Can you mute yourself, please, Evo? Cheers, mate. It's it. That's dodgy. Nice job, mate.
Yes! Excellent lap. We're all very, very pleased with that one. Nice work! Come on, I'll see you back in the pits.
I'll take them. Oh no! Wow! Holy! Evo! You're second fastest of anyone in Sector 1. Yep. Doesn't even look that wet. You can't anyway. No, you're locked to wet. Oh, I hate that word, mate. Should. It's my least favourite word in the English language. I've left mine the same. I think balance is more important, but... I think it's Beastie always does it on formation lap. This will be my first time in the wet here. Oh god, people's... Guess that. Feels weird seeing metal in a tribe.
Change in the weather throughout this entire session.
Oh mate, this race is gonna be horrid. Oh god, in the wet, yeah, that's gonna be horrid. This race is going to be horrendous, oh my lord. Don't try not to kill me, please, pirate. What are you... Oh, dodgy. I didn't think it could be wetter, so I've not done a lap.
Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid...
What a way to start the season. A Vegas F2 wet. Good luck.
An incident on track, but officials aren't looking to push for a safety car right now. Just be careful. Virtual safety car, virtual safety car. Reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta.
My tyres are already on 8%. Oh yeah. Oh, Mash is in my old car. Who's top three? Goat. I think everybody backed off too much. I had like 3.5 seconds on my delta.
Until we get the green flags. VSC ending. Wait for the greens.
Yeah, me too, mate. I'm on 11% on the rears. Dude, this is the problem with high winds. Thank you, mate. That wasn't the most convenient corner.
Caution.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, this is going as well as expected. What the hell is this? Have you got damage at all, Dodger? Mate, we could be on for 1-2 here. Possibly the most chaotic opening few laps I've ever seen. Oh god, no, ABS is horrid. Another VSC.
We need to give a positive delta here. Slow down and maintain a positive delta.
Yeah, this is what a mad start. Carito's leading right now. I'm chasing him down. I'm on 19% tires already. Fourteen front, 19 rears.
Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta's negative, which means you're going too fast. Reduce your pace.
I'm glad for the VSC though, because it's allowed me to do some much needed tyre saving.
Okay, VSC ending. We're going green. Maintain
well, that was fast.
Delta until the green flags.
It come up that it was ending for me, but it was like, end it. Okay, gone. Do you want some advice for this chicaney bit? Go over to the left. Go over to the left, brake and stuff. Carito's really struggling in this section, for example. I'm not going to actually go for the move here on Carito, but I'm going to pressure him into a mistake. I can't risk going for anything. I've lost so much time through that.
Okay, this guy's actually hard to overtake.
Oh, I faked the move and just happened to brake a lot later.
Brilliant, nice move, keep going.
Kurito's hit the wall through there, whether he's got damage or not, I don't know, but he's lost 8 tenths to me. There, his TT's 16-10 if he's running anything similar. Seriously concerned about getting to the end there. Yeah.
Good job, that was the fastest lap of the race so far.
Deliberately not going as quick as I can, I'm just trying to save the tyres right now. Crashes all over the place. What's going on in front of you?
So we're leading our teammate by 6.7 seconds.
I don't think we'll be getting a restart either.
No need to worry about the tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good.
One 56.8. gap to P5 is 17.4 seconds.
Still with me.
What, sorry? Yep, including this one, 3 laps after.
Of minor damage.
From what?
Woohoo! I almost crashed.
Yeah, mate, I've almost crashed. I've just whacked my brake bias all the way up to 58.
That is 61. Thank you. crash at front chicane. What a crazy race. This is one I'm gonna look forward to watching back on stream. Yeah, that's what I mean, to see what on earth happened. Ghosting's definitely on, isn't it? Oh my gosh, there's two of them. I deliberately took a different line through there because I didn't want to come off the corner and smash into a car that hasn't ghosted. I'm on 69, nice, percent, 70. As you mean to go on. Come on! Yes. Great drive, dodgy. You're quick here. It's okay. Hold on, we got to fight for 11th place here. Can Kvyat break himself? Can Otto capitalise? Is it? Yeah, it is. Ha 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 ha. is, mate. Not bad for a number two driver. Yeah, I've got a feeling Beast doesn't like me for some reason. I feel bad for Kurita and that he shouldn't have pit at all. If he didn't pit, he'd have been battling with you for 4th, 5th, I reckon. I don't know, when I overtook him, he had slight contact, and then a few corners afterwards, you know, when he was about a second behind, he hit the wall sector 2, lost about a second. So I can only assume that he just smashed the wall. But I don't know. Yep. Good man. I'll be back in a few minutes. Hello. What's happening, lovelies? Mate, trust me, if there's anything last season taught me, it's to be patient. Okay, I can now confirm. What wings are you running even? Oh my gosh.
We're not seeing any technical issues.
What were you running?
Watch the RPM on the full start.
Like, when you said in the one-shot quali. Yeah. I'm minus three on both. 24-18. What position are you, Dodgy? You're seven? Six.
We think it'll stay dry.
Oh, we're all on the top, so that's good then. If that happens, I think that'll be the last time you two are in a party together. Good luck warming up these tyres, by the way, I'm on 80 on the front. Let's see if the F1 thing will help me at all by going 70% brake bias. It's a nightmare. This is why you need such high pressures, because even if you can get the temperature, they don't hold it. Oh god.
Okay, not
the I slightly unbroke myself.
Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights.
I slightly unbroke myself. What could possibly go wrong here? Famous last words. It's at one corner. Oh dear.
Right, drop your speed. Our delta's too low and we're going to risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately.
I need to get away from the middle as quickly as I can. Both the VARs, isn't it, at the back? What position are you dodgy? No, so you're still... okay. Why is the... this is so stupid. I have one lap to get out of medals, DRS. I'd like to get medal out of mine. He who says he will perform badly will. He who says he will perform well might. Oh, what's happened? What happened, mate? Lap 9, I reckon. If I was you, I'd want it right as soon as you can. The earlier it comes out, the deader, the worse our tyres are going to be. You know what I'm trying to say, and definitely completely fine English. Thank you. in the pits. Power quits. I'm also slash hoping that's in the pits it is. Oh, I think Benz has made a mistake. No way, Benz has lost 1.3 seconds in one sector in pure pace. Oh, medals. So annoying in this situation. Has made a mistake.
Okay, mate, don't worry about the damage. I've got some new strategy options if you go and check your MFD.
I hate it when it does that. Okay, mate, don't worry about the damage. I've not hit the wall once this race. No.
Got that, confirmed.
I think it can only happen if it's simulation damage, so can't it? You got anyone, or like many people behind you, Dodgy? What tyres? What tyres? No, what tyres is he on? Thinking, you know, what's the likelihood of you keeping P5? Yeah. You should undercut Matt, but the advantage we're going to have on fresh supers is ridiculous. What percent you on? Oh wow. I'm on 30. On softs. Blue flags waving. Is that for the? Who's your teammate? No. Of course, Medal's not going to answer, is it? Because he's not in the bloody party. Anyone know who Medal's teammate is? Dodgy. Do you know who his teammate is? No. Let's look at, there's a Trident under blue flags right now. And there's also Owen. Who... Yeah. It's just, you lose a lot of time on this train now. So it's amazing how much quicker having high down force is, considering the kind of track it is. I mean, a lot of people using like 10.9 or something around that.
Gap to your teammate behind is 15.3 seconds.
Your tyre's starting to go off a bit now, Dodgy. Oh, you put, yeah. Let's say you've... think I got one. Either Matt will react to it and pit this lap, in which case he's going to be on dead supers by the end, or he won't and you'll get the undercut on him. It's a win-win for you right now. Eight or nine, I'll put. He's going for the undercut. Wow. That undercut must have been huge then. You was like 5 seconds behind him. Was this a huge failure, man? You see, he's around 10 seconds behind, but obviously every little helps me. And then next lap I'll box lap 9. Thank you very much. Medals pit, as I said. Okay, Beast is pit. Wow, something has jumped fence there. Wait, I was going to say how's that happened, then realised you held him up. Now, will Benster and Southerner fight as teammates? That'll be an interesting one. Oh, the words that would be shared in chat. No point risking anything. Benz, not pit.
Okay, let's go now. Perfect job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop.
They've both got passed by the looks of it.
Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres.
What, with DRS? Yeah. But I can't either. Oh wow. Christ, how much did you all bent through up? He's got a 2-lap medal. Yes, there's another Trident there, who's a lap down. Husky Saturn. Dodgy, can I just say, mate? Bentster was 10 seconds behind when he come out. Well, when he pit. He's had a 2-lap undercut and he's now 16 seconds behind. What did he do to that man? I owe you a pint, mate. Yeah, you don't quite top out at 2:03 in the race. But I don't think you'd do that even with... Unless you use like 0:0, I don't think you'd do that anyway. Oh, please, Owen, give me DRS. Oh, Owen, I love you.
Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far.
How come? Oh, that's annoying. I set a perfect sector one that's a quarter of a second quicker, but now I'm not going to have DRS. So I'm going to lose all of that. Tell you what, I'm 4/10 up before the start of the DRS zone, 385 milliseconds. Let's see what that gap goes to. back to 1.5 tenths.
Yep. Good job, mate. What tires you on now? Oh god. What lap did you pit? You pit end of lap 2? Mate, you'll have to pit this lap then, I think you'll be disqualified. You have to wait till the end of lap 3 for your mandatory start. Have you not had a warning come up about it? You have to wait till the end of lap 3 for your mandatory stop, I think. Yeah. What position are you now? It's up to you whether you want to take the risk. It's 4 points. Only to lose. Fair point.
Okay, this is your final lap. Final lap of the race.
And then as soon as we finish tonight, there's no more F2 for 3 weeks. You've been disqualified? Oh my god. No. Unlucky, mate. Portugal. That could be my most dominant F2 track. I come across the line then. Here to start season 9. Finished as we left off last season. It's another 39 points. Get in! Whew. I know you've always wanted to witness one of them live. No! Cheers, mate. Yeah, good job, mate. I'm gutted. Carito is in 11th, about to make a move for 10th. But he's got a penalty. Good job, mate. 4th and 5th. Oh. QWERTY 10 second penalty for corner. Here we go. I guarantee the Punisher's gonna push Carito in the wall now. No, he hasn't. Good job, mate. Oh, you've just retired from the session, apparently, either.
I've got podium interview now. GG, mate. Did I say tonight? Obviously, next race is in 3 weeks. I won't sweat it too much, but if there is any point, you know, my setup will just be my TT one. So if there's any point, you know, you want to do practice or anything, then you know, let me know. Yeah. All right, speak to you soon, mate. GG tonight. Well done.
No, we tried it. To be fair, it wasn't so bad in the dry. Maybe in the next game it'd be better, but in the wet, it was absolutely horrendous, as I found out. Apologies, Benster. That was absolutely atrocious. I've clipped it just for on my own entertainment because it was so bad. It showed the skill on track. You could see in the gaps, Griffiths at the front, Medel and Benster were on another level as well. Then there was me, Dodgy. So it was kind of actually reminiscent to first races last season. I thought it would be completely different, but it was kind of similar. Same sprint pole sitter, same drivers up the top, same drivers best of the rest. If it wasn't for the wet race, I would have said it was a success. Who knows? We might see it back on the calendar. We'll see what the drivers have to say. We'll see what's said in the admin chat. From my own perspective of the race, I'll take it. Best of the rest. Fortunate to finish where I finished in the first race, and it was quite chilled and lonely in the second race. Good points for PHM Racing. It's nice to have a driver like Benster as a teammate, because I think if we're here most weeks, we could really challenge, hopefully, Toby and Dodgy for the constructors. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I think. My strength's always been, I've not been the quickest driver, but my consistency's been great. And thankfully, Benster is very similar, just a little bit quicker, as we saw in that race. So hopefully we can do bits. Hopefully the consistency will be able to keep the pressure on Toby. And who knows, hopefully we can be crowned Constructor Champions at the end of the season.
Yeah, we're going to Benster then. A strong, I say, P2 in the sprint race, and in the featured you managed to bring it P3. Was you trying your hardest to in the feature then to close the medal? Obviously you could get the P2 all round if you were to get past medal. Was it that the goal, or were you just happy staying in P3?
To be honest, got wing damage because I decided to drive into the wall. In the first stint, which I wasn't very impressed with, but what can you do? And then I obviously made the very foolish mistake of changing your wing in F2. That costs you all of any time. So I lost about 9 seconds in the pits or something ridiculous, and that was race over, effectively. Dropped us right back, and Medal's no slouch. I'm not gaining. I've barely gained any time, if any, to be honest. Shows the pace of the guys at the front. So yeah, race of what could have been maybe, but I certainly wasn't challenging for the win. There was only one man who was getting that.
Fair enough. Put us in the cockpit of the wet, because obviously we saw a lot of drivers going on like struggling to brake, so it was going straight on. But like, how was it in the wet for you? Like, how did you manage to cope with the brake issues, or were you just braking early enough to make sure you was going, or was you just, you know, just risking it?
Well, I think it was lap two. I broke for turn one, and Southern opted for a slightly different approach and didn't, and completely destroyed us. But it was all right. I styled it out with a 360, and we moved on. But besides that, I mean, I think I've just put the brake bias forward a little bit, and try my best to correct any slides on entry. But yeah, obviously braking a little bit earlier, because the last thing you want to do is hit the car in front, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, I mean, that was a strong weekend for you. Definitely for the PTM as well. So, I mean, strong point for both of you, to be fair. And I'll give it to Corey to give it to the P2 guy.
I found the pace overall to be pretty good. I knew coming into this, Toby was going to be pretty difficult to even match, consistently being about a second off of him in practice, or whatever. So I knew I had no chance of him. I'm still upset he didn't give me at least one lap in DRS, but overall, yeah, pretty happy. I did see Benson behind, and I was worried for a few laps at the feature that he was going to become an issue, but I just kept it consistent, and yeah, lucky got damage in the end. I did hear him clatter the wall as well, so I was like, okay, that makes my race a little easier, but it made it quite boring, I must say. I think possibly if there's tracks which suit me more, maybe I could fight him a little harder, but yeah, definitely P2's definitely the target, but snagging a win here and there when he makes a mistake is probably what the goal is for me, probably. Yeah.
That mistake's done this season now, that's it.
Yep. I know.
I mean, is there any point?
Thank you very much.
But yeah, I mean, that was a comfortable. I mean, I don't know if it's comfortable for you in the cockpit in the wet, but I mean, it looked comfortable. You just managed every single bit of the track. I mean, I don't know how you feel about a wet Vegas, but surely you hope it's behind you now. I hope you don't want to see the track ever again in F2. But yeah, how was your race in your eyes?
Yeah, I'm obviously chuffed to start the season kind of as I left off last season, really. Coming into today, I knew, you know, I've had a setup in my pocket for a few weeks, and deliberately not told anybody about it, and I think that is a lot of the reason for my advantage. And then it's just, you know, applying it, really, making sure not to make any mistakes. I had one moment in the sprint. I think I was going for fastest lap, and coming into the hairpin, I very nearly span and completely lost it all. So I took my brake bias and definitely cooled it down from there. But yeah, I'm happy to keep it going from last season. Portugal next time out, obviously probably another one of my strongest tracks in F2. I want the double. I want the back to back this season. So it's just about trying to make that work, really.
That's for I mean, obviously you got the. You're gonna have a constructors battle on your hand. Do you feel like that'll be close towards the end, or do you feel like you're comfortable with your teammate to, you know, finish ahead of some of these the PHM drivers?
It could go either way, honestly. I predicted before the start of the season, as soon as I saw that PHM lineup, you know, I didn't think that. Well, I knew that we'd have a really good challenge on our hands. Obviously, it depends on just how the season goes, really. It could go 50-50, but it should be a nice, good battle all season long, right to the end. Which is exactly, you know, what we can ask for. It gives us something to work towards.
Well, congrats on the two wins and the 2 points, obviously, getting pole position and qualifying. I mean, must be chuffed to get an all big scoring points all around the weekend.
Thank you very much.
And I'll give the scores to end off the stream.
Yeah!